Good afternoon. My name is Johnny Giles. I'm the Chief of Staff for Huntsville City Schools, and I will be your narrator for today's event. We are here for the ribbon cutting of the Huntsville High School new Freshman Academy, and I think that deserves a round of applause. This is definitely a momentous occasion, not just for Huntsville High School, but for Huntsville City Schools. And so we wanted to give you a little bit of a background behind the project, how this project came to be, and the impact it'll have on our community. The individuals up front will be speaking to you briefly on what this actually means to the city of Huntsville, and I'll introduce each one of them as their time comes. To start us out, Ms. Laurie McCaulley, our Vice President of the Board of Education. Ms. McCaulley.
But I want to talk to you about this ninth grade academy, or freshman academy, whatever you want to call it. It is the model for Huntsville City Schools. It will be how the other two freshman academies will be constructed. There are many safety issues in this building. Some we can tell you about, some we cannot. But what we can tell you is we have the ability now from the front office to lock all doors electronically. So if there is an intruder or stranger in the building, we're able to isolate them in our corridors. You will also be able to see that there is escape routes from every classroom because they're connected. But the other features, he's talking to Homeland Security about, he won't y'all know that. But I do want you to know that every other academy, this is the model. So we would want you to know that every one of our children in Huntsville City Schools mean the same to us. And I want to give you this short, brief story. And there was two friends that were walking along one day, and one found a penny. And he said, oh, look at that Scrooge. He's going to pick that penny up. He says, no. Yes, penny does make dollars, but that's not why I pick pennies up. He said, look on back of the penny, and what did you see engraved? He said, oh, in God we trust. So he said, this is an opportunity every time you see a penny to say a short prayer to your God. Then he said, but that's still not why I pick up pennies. He said, so if I find a dirty penny, or if I find a shiny penny, or if I find a penny that has been cut up, you know what I do? He said, no, I pick them all up and put them in a safe place. I put them in a bank, or I put them in a piggy bank, but I pick them up and I make them better. Well, that's how the children come to us in Huntsville City Schools. Some come to us into this academy, all beat up from the elements in life in which they live. Some will come to us all bright and shiny. But at the end of the day, they all have the same value in Huntsville City Schools. And thank you once again from the Huntsville Board of Education.
I don't think Mr. Giles mentioned that I'm a graduate of Huntsville High School, but we never had anything close to this, not even a whisper. And can you imagine, on the first day of school, when these ninth graders walk in here, and they realize that they are probably in the safest place to be in this city, and all this modern technology to help them learn and advance. Well, welcome to the latest crown jewel of the many, many crown jewels in the Huntsville City School System. Thank you again for coming in.
I am honored to have an opportunity to speak with you briefly this afternoon about this wonderful Freshman Academy. I went to school, high school, many, many years ago on the south side of Chicago with over 4,000 students, and I really could have benefited by having a freshman academy and not have to deal with all of those students in the same setting every day. But I say that to say we are excited about this wonderful freshman academy that, as Ms. McCaulley has said, will become a model for learning in Huntsville City Schools. Most of us know that the research indicates that ninth grade is oftentimes the year where you will start to lose students and they will start to fall behind. The ninth grade academy gives us an opportunity to successfully transition our students into high school and really give us that extra year with them to mold them and make sure that they are ready for that 10th grade year. We have a wonderful curriculum that we will be implementing. This will become the model for future freshman academies. We actually have freshman academies in all of our high schools. We just don't have the separate buildings for all of them. but all future buildings will be built with this feature. Welcome back to a wonderful school year. We look forward to engaging with our parents and community, and we hope that you're going to be very visible and help us to make this freshman academy the success that we know it can be. Thank you so much for being here and for coming out to spend this time with us this afternoon.
And to be honest with you, I didn't know what to expect as far as a crowd tonight. This is great. I mean, this is wonderful. We're excited about the opening. And first of all, I want to thank everybody that was involved in the construction process. I mean, I know if you've driven by school, you'll notice that there's a lot of things been going on. We had no disruption to any of our school programs. Thank you to all of you for making that a priority. The opening of this building tonight results in many positives for our students. First of all, we're very overcrowded last year with the addition of over 25 classrooms in this building, as you'll see a little bit later on tonight. That problem's been alleviated. We also have room to expand our instructional programs. There were some programs that we had, such as some of our engineering classes, health science, emergency technician, and also our entertainment technology that we kind of had to put on hold a little bit until we had room. We have room now, and you'll see those programs just start to grow. And then lastly, we can now provide an environment for our freshmen that will facilitate a smooth transition for them as they go from middle school to high school. In addition to these instructional benefits, this freshman academy is equipped with up-to-date technology, and it has designated extended learning areas that will provide students with an enhanced educational environment. And you'll see those tonight as part of your tour. This building also has a lot of new safety features, such as a reinforced area to protect our students during severe weather, which you'll see down this hallway to my left. The tour guides will call that to your attention. And there's also a lot of security measures that we have in place to help protect our students from intruders. As you tour the building, I would like for you to be aware of changes, not just here, but also to other parts of our campus due to the construction. We have increased the number of parking places. Yes, we have. Still not enough, but we have increased them. All right, we also have new tennis courts that are way on the west side of campus, which are beautiful. And the landscaping that you see has been completed, and all those factors together just make this beautiful campus that you're going to see tonight. So take the time to look outside. Everything has come together very well. Thank you for coming tonight, and I hope you enjoyed the tour, and I feel that you'll be impressed. Thank you.
It's a real honor to be here to represent Mayor Tommy Battle, who unfortunately is out of town, but would love to be here himself. You know, our community demands a great deal of Huntsville City Schools. We expect to have great schools within our system, and I think that we do. But I tell you, to have great schools, we have to have great principals, we have to have great teachers. We've got to have rigorous curriculum. We've got to have a lot of materials to deliver that curriculum. We have to have active, involved parents making a difference in the students' lives when they leave the doors of the school. And there's a lot of other resources that the system has to bring to bear to really deliver the great schools that we demand of them. One of those things is great buildings. Oftentimes those get forgotten in the process. We focus so much on the kids that we forget that we need buildings that are laid out efficiently. We need buildings that enable the teachers to deliver that rigorous curriculum. And I want to say thanks to the leadership of the school system for focusing so much on ensuring those types of resources are available. It absolutely makes a difference in the way the system runs. It makes a difference in the way the teachers are able to deliver that curriculum. It makes a difference in the way the students learn as they leave these doors and go on and find challenging careers. So we are proud to be partnered with Huntsville City School System and proud to be opening this new facility. I think it's just one of many more to come. So thank you.
Well, you know, most of you know I come out of the Army, and I taught at West Point a long time, and I really, when we have these ceremony kind of things, you know, I really kind of drive my program managers crazy, because I mean, I want the grass to, you know, to be just, you know, to just a certain sort of level and things like that. Kind of like at West Point, you know, on graduation day, it always looks like a picture postcard. I would defy anybody to find one single leaf on the plane. You won't. Well, if you noticed when you came in tonight, it didn't quite look like that. I mean, you couldn't help but notice a portalette. You could have noticed a couple of people out there with a hose. There's definitely some of that red clay out there in the parking lot. Behind you and around you, you're looking at stacks of boxes. And there are also other, flotsam and jetsam of construction that you're going to see around the facility tonight. And to all of that, I'd like to say bravo. I'm glad that you're seeing that tonight. I'm glad you're seeing it all, because you know what? It reminds us that the finished product is this beautiful example of what happens when many artisans, many craftspeople, many talented professionals from a multiplicity of disciplines come together and create. And when you look at some of the things that I've been talking about, it reminds us all that this building, with all its technology, with all its innovations, this building was built by women and men, one brick at a time. And I would just ask you that if you are to see any of our women and men tonight, and I would just like to recognize the firms, our project manager, our project management firm, TCU. I've got Andy Bernard here tonight from TCU. The wonderful design professionals from Nola Van Pearson Architects, Kathy Riggs and Rob Van Pearson here with us tonight. Programming the building, the way it even looks, the reason it looks like it does because of Tracy Richter and Carrie Ann Wolf and their fine team. And of course, we can't forget the people, who literally put the brick and mortar together, Lee Builders Incorporated, Bruce Lee and Steve McWhorter. Please remember that this wonderful facility was in fact built one brick at a time, and we thank all of those women and men who have worked so hard and employed so many different talents to lay the foundation for the future for the students of Huntsville City Schools. Thank you.
I graduated from Huntsville High School also in 1973. We moved away after college down to Fort Lauderdale and moved back here in 1984. And it wasn't long after that that brought my three young children up to Huntsville High to a wrestling meet. And as we got out of the car and were walking to the gym, I think they were probably about two ages apart, two years apart, probably about four or six and eight. I said, "Kids, did y'all know your dad went to high school here?" My oldest turned to the two youngest and said, "Yeah, but it was one-room schoolhouse at that time." Well, it wasn't a one-room schoolhouse, but I tell you, it wasn't this either. This is an awesome facility. So on behalf of the Huntsville Chamber of Commerce, we'd like to present this plaque today to commemorate this great day and the construction of this great facility. And I present that to always Coach Mincher, to me, as he coached my youngest son in baseball.